There are some opponents and critics of ethanol who are trying to dismantle the RFS too. That's very important to the industry. I find it funny that they call that the ethanol a mandate when you're only allowed to sell a legal fuel in this country, and that's by ASTM standards, and that's a fossil fuel. So until ethanol came along, we had a mandate to buy fossil fuels. Ethanol is the only choice that you have to break that mandate. So if you have any questions, you know, I know you've supported the renewable fuels industry in the past, and hopefully we'll continue to do so as the next president.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And I can tell you this, that I believe ethanol is an important part of our fuel solution, our energy solution. I supported the subsidy of ethanol to help get the industry on its feet. I've indicated I didn't think the subsidy had to go on forever. As in most efforts of this nature, you want to get an industry to be competitive and then stand on its own feet. The ethanol subsidy, I understand, expires in December, and I might have looked at more of a decline over time, as your senator suggested, but it's now been decided that's going to be gone in December. And most people I know in the ethanol industry say, fine, you know, we're now up and going. In the early days, as I understand it, for about every BTU of ethanol that came out, it took almost a BTU of energy to go in. Now it's about 2.4 BTUs of energy out for each BTU going in. So it's become an important source of amplifying our energy capacity in this country. For me, ethanol is part of national security. It is part of America, developing part of our own energy, and that is a domestic fuel, which is renewable. Those two features, domestic and renewable, are both positive. And I would like to see the ethanol industry continue to be successful, to grow, and to provide a growing share of America's domestic energy sources. And how to do that, I will, as Russ Perot used to say, I'm all ears. We'll talk about the best ways to encourage that. I'm not promoting new subsidies for ethanol. That ends as of December. But I do believe that we should recognize the importance of ethanol as a domestic fuel and as an alternative to buying energy from other nations, some of them don't like us very much. So, one of the things that struck me in meeting with, I've got the corn growers over here, you guys are related, I know. When I was a boy, the kind of numbers, help me with my memory on this, an acre could produce about 60 bushels of corn. Today it produces about 160 bushels of corn. Is that about right?
Yeah, pretty close.
Pretty close. And it'll produce a lot more as time goes on. That's not over. The progress is going to continue. And so the ability of our land to produce more and more product continues to grow, and that product can be an important part of our energy solution. So I'm a friend of ethanol, and at the same time, I don't want to say that I'm going to be proposing new legislation to provide new subsidies. I think that time is now completed, and we'll move on to encourage the availability of the American public to purchase ethanol, as you say, on a choice basis. Let people have the choice of the fuels they want to put in their vehicles. Thanks, Rick.
Thank you.
I don't know, you